All right, we are going to show off our squirrel skinning jig that I made last week or the week before, I don't remember. So first, you hook the legs in the back slot. I like to pull the fur off like so. Just pinch that fur between your knife blade and your finger. And you're trying to just get access to the base of the tail. Easy peasy. Then we're just cutting at the base of the tail. Just trying to get through that bone. And not cut all the way through. It's not always easy. If you get too carried away at that joint, you will go all the way through. Like that. Every time. That's not what's supposed to happen. Anyway, so, it's easier with the tail on, but it's still doable. So now we're going to go around the hip pocket. Just open that up. Put the knife on the little shelf there. And then you hook your fingers in. Pull straight down. This squirrel is super fresh, so... Get off their hair. Go through down to the wrists. Down to the wrists. Hook through that wrist. Hook through that wrist. Seen videos of guys using scissors. I never bring scissors out here with me. Do not cut the head off. You need the head on for the second part. Now we hook our head in that pocket like so. Try to tuck that fur out of the way where you're not getting fur on stuff. This one's furrier than the last one I did. Now you just need a little bit of fur to grab onto. And then you just grab and pull them down. Like so and like so. I do not usually have the best of luck on these back ankles. Now you just open that belly up for gutting. Easy. And away the guts go. There are chickens here. We throw it into the chickens for them to play with. And then you can do this while it's still up there. I like to take it off. Cut around the head. That's it. You got a pretty clean squirrel carcass. Easier than trying to hold on it or stand on it or do any of that.